midget man, tennis preacher, y'all know the prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, Andre Agassi, who was the Djokovic's coach, parted ways with the Djokovic. I don't know if it was last week, couple weeks, but I think it was officially announced, like, the last couple of days or so. And what do I think about that? And what does that tell me about whether or not the Djokovic can make a successful comeback? Now, let me just say this here. I couldn't get too much information from the Djokovic or Agassi, because both of them, they didn't want to embarrass each other or put out, you know, stuff that's probably none of our business. And definitely, like, personal feelings they could have towards each other. I don't gather that it's something personal, though, because I could tell the way Agassi sort of talked. He said, we agree to disagree. So Agassi sort of kept it on a really politically correct level. You know, he didn't really, you could tell he didn't want to badmouth the Djokovic. And the Djokovic didn't want to badmouth him, which is all good. I mean, I don't think it was anything like deep personal stuff or some personal hatred. I think it was just like Agassi said, that they disagreed on how the Djokovic should come back. And so they are parted ways here. So let me just say something about that. Okay, coaches and players part ways all the time. Whether the player is trying to make a comeback or just a player just needs a new coach. So this is normal that a coach and a player will part ways, especially if the player is losing and frustrated the way the Djokovic is right now. The way the Djokovic is losing right now and having problems, getting on the right path. Now, I did tell y'all that it's going to take time. So I got to sort of use my own intuition, my own knowledge of the game, and just my own, interpretation of what's happening with the Djokovic, because like I said before, Agassi didn't really say what they disagree about. See, if Agassi would have came out and said, listen, I told you Djokovic, he needs to be patient, or he needs to work on this, or he needs to get his body back in shape first, or it's going to take this amount of time, then I could say, okay, Agassi was right, or the Djokovic was wrong. So I'm going to sort of have to guess who probably was right, okay? And that ain't really just the purpose of the video to say who was right between Agassi and the Djokovic. The purpose of this video is to really talk about, will the Djokovic make a successful comeback? Okay, but let me just deal with this Agassi thing. If you had to ask me, imagine, man, who do you think was probably right? Do you think Agassi, whatever he was telling the Djokovic that we don't know about, that the Djokovic rejected, And caused Agassi to say, well, we need to part ways and just agree to disagree the way Agassi said. Do you think Agassi was probably more right, or the Djokovic was probably more right? Okay, people, let me just say this here. First of all, the Djokovic's problems that he's having right now, it's going to take more than just an Agassi or any coach to solve it. Some of the things that I'm sensing from the Djokovic, his mentality right now, whatever's, and also he used the word personal a lot, that there are some personal things that's happened in his life, or that there is personal stuff still going on that's affecting his own court play. And we know he was injured too, but so I think a lot of the problem, if you had to ask me, is this more of an Agassi problem or the Djokovic problem? Well, first of all, this ain't no Agassi problem, because the Djokovic was already having problems before Agassi got on board, okay? So now, if you're asking me, do you think the Djokovic is more right with whatever philosophy the Djokovic got? Is he more right, or was he more right, or was Agassi more right? I can tell you right now, people, it's probably Agassi. Whatever Agassi was telling the Djokovic and he rejected, Agassi was probably more right. And you might say, well, why would you say that? Well, I'll tell you why I'm saying it. I know one thing. If Agassi wasn't right, I know the Djokovic ain't right. Well, he definitely ain't got the right philosophy. Because I know I said it's going to take time, but still, what I'm hearing from the Djokovic, he seemed to got some issues up in his head, too. So if you had this, back to the question, if you ask me, do you think the advice Agassi was giving him was better for the Djokovic than whatever the Djokovic's advice he was giving to himself? Obviously, the advice the Djokovic is giving to himself is not working. And it don't seem like it's going to work. Like I said, it's going to take time, but it don't seem like it's going to work. Okay? And so that's it for that there. That's all I can say about that. That the Djokovic, I think the point is, forget this Agassi being right versus the Djokovic. That's not even the purpose of the video. I think the Djokovic still got some personal issues that needs to be dealt with. And it's going to be up to the Djokovic to change his mentality now, because this is a new territory for him. See, now we're finna get somewhere now. Okay, people, this is the purpose of the video right here. People, the Djokovic got one of the top 5 years of all time, if not the top. Between the Djokovic, Rod Laver, and Federer, whichever one of those you want to choose. And the Djokovic, somebody argued that the Djokovic 5 years is a little better than Federer's 5 years or Rod Laver's 5 years. They could have an argument there. But it's close between those guys. There's a lot of factors to look at. But definitely, the Djokovic got, between those three, one of the best 5 years, if not the best 5 years of all time in all tennis history. And I also told y'all, the Djokovic got the highest level I've ever seen on the court. So I'm giving the Djokovic props. But I also said this here. The reason why the Djokovic could have been the GOAT, but he's not the GOAT. And the reason why he's not the GOAT could have been if he had been able to sustain those 5 years for like three more years, winning like three majors each year. If he would have been able to do that, I know he got injured and then he had the personal issues too. But hey, that's what makes you great. He was not able to do it. I don't care about the reason why he was not able to do it. He was not able to sustain those 5 years. And that's why he's not greater than Nadal or Federer. I'm talking about greater. Now, you could argue he's a better player, that you could take those 5 years that the Djokovic had, like I said, that peak, and say he's the best player of all time. If somebody said that, I wouldn't have a huge problem with that. If they said during those 5 years, he could have been the best player. Now, I could come back and argue, well, Nadal and Federer and Rod Laver, they were the better players if you said more than 5 years. Now, that more than 5 years, people, that got a lot to do with this video. Okay, people, Federer and Nadal, who I got over the Djokovic for his greatness. Now, I got the Djokovic, he's right under Nadal. I mean, if you want to put him equal, say, well, even though even though the Djokovic got only 12 majors, I think because he got so many other great statistics and record break. You go to Wikipedia, the Djokovic, his statistics blow up Wikipedia. I treat the Djokovic like he got 15 or 16 majors. So, but I still won't put him over Nadal, but I can put him in Nadal's category though. But right under Nadal. That's why I got the Djokovic as far as greatness is concerned. Not better player. Now, you can argue he's a better player than Nadal, okay? I got that, but I'm talking about greatness now. People, listen.